A lovely Tuesday afternoon to you. I am Dylan Radigan, and today's big story, Auction 2012 continues. Another presidential primary day obviously doesn't matter in the sense that it is a done deal for Mitt Romney, even Newt Gingrich getting the hint, suggesting that he might drop out after tonight's results when the folks at NBC talk to him. But there are congressional primaries today that do matter. For a layer of reasons. For instance, Pennsylvania today, holding primaries to determine which Republican will challenge Democratic Senator Bob Casey this fall. Two incumbent House Democrats, meanwhile, are facing off thanks to gerrymandering in the redistricting process. So, you know, it's a screwball, but you got to get in there and work on it. While other Democratic congressmen now risk losing his seat to a primary challenge. This is encouraging, not from the partisan politics, but from the fact that there is debate. As we know, a major factor in winning any election or auction is money. 94% of the winning candidates had more cash than their opponents in 2008. It's a fact. That's why I call it an auction. There's also now all that newfound super secret super PAC money to consider. Less than 200 people. This is the big thing. Less than 200 people. 196 people, to be precise. Paid the bill for nearly 80%, $4 out of $5, for all individual contributions to every super PAC for every issue in 2011. 196 people. There are 311 million of us. Meanwhile, $110 million, which is more than half of all the money the super PACs raised since the start of 2011, came from 46 human beings, businesses, or organizations. There are 311 million of us, countless businesses and organizations. 46 of them, we'll call them the oligarchs, provide the money. A new poll shows that 69% of Americans say that this unlimited secret money will lead to corruption. You don't say. And that means, and this is the tragedy, this is where we have to work. The response right now is that 7 in 10 voters are saying they're going to sit out because they know it's a foregone conclusion through rigged secret money, gerrymandering, uncontested primaries. But our guests today say you are right to feel this degree of anxiety and despair. But that the response is not hope and not anger, but action, and the action is directly contrary to your instinct. You want to disengage. They say, no, no, no. Engage now more than you ever have, because this country needs us more than it ever has. We start with Ari Berman, contributing writer for The Nation, who brought some of those horrifying statistics to our attention, and Mark Meckler, who is now senior advisor for the Campaign for Primary Accountability, which is effectively a coalition leading this counterintuitive proposal. You guys were nodding. You understand, Mark, I lay out these statistics. People watch my show. People read, and they're like, I'm out. I'm not watching MSNBC. I'm not watching Fox. I don't want any. I'm out of here. You understand that, but argue that it is the most dangerous, worst possible thing, and that we must do the precisely the exact opposite, which is you've now left the Tea Party. You're now doing it. Why?
Well, because this is precisely what the politicians want, Dylan. They want us to disengage. This is what these giant corporations who pay the politicians want. They want us disengaged.
Why would they want that?
Because if we're disengaged, they maintain the status quo. The status quo is a two-party system, but that two-party system is the incumbents versus the citizens. The citizens are losing. We can win if we engage, but we must engage.
Your thoughts on his, basically, Mark's antidote to the problem that you so wonderfully statistically presented to all of us.
Well, I do think we need more competition in American politics, and so I think it's good that we're getting more people to run in primary campaigns, with a caveat. The caveat being that if we just put new people into the same broken system, we're going to get the same results, which is what happened in 2010. All these new people,
or 28
people, got in there. 2008, all the new Obama people get in there. Same broken system in Washington, same results 2008, 2010. So we don't want to repeat that in 2012.
How do you reconcile that?
Well, the way we fix it is we engage in primaries. And traditionally, we don't engage in primaries.
We who?
We, the American people. 11.5% of Democrats or of Republicans vote in the primaries, 8.5% of Democrats. It's dismal. So we're not engaging. This is a weak spot in the system for the incumbents. If we engage, we can change the results. It's inexpensive. It doesn't take a lot of us voting. That's what the Campaign for Primary Accountability is about. It's to get citizens engaged in the primaries, both parties. It's nonpartisan, non-ideological. That's what makes politicians responsive. If they know we can throw them out, they respond to Main Street instead of K Street.
They have an interesting method. which is to, it's 50-50, right? 50 Republicans, 50 Democrats, looking for the lowest rated incumbents overall in the district in heavily gerrymandered districts where they can't get thrown out. That seems remarkably logical to me. Am I missing something?
It does. The other problem, though, that I have a little bit with the group, Mark, is that you're also playing big super PAC money in these races. So you're going in, you're dumping a lot of money on TV, just like all the other super PAC groups are doing.
Fire with fire.
Can you do that kind of politics and then turn around and then say, okay, now we want to reform the system?
I think you can. What we are is we're a citizen-oriented super PAC. Again, because it's not policy, it's not ideology, nobody owes us anything. It really has nothing to do with us. The entire idea is to create a representative democracy. If these people are unpopular with their constituents, we're going to go after them. If they're popular, it doesn't matter what their policies are. If they're well-liked by their constituents, they're safe from us.
If you were to look at some of the other, because really what you're getting at is, we can agree, 196 people, a lot of money. Primary engagement is we can do it now. It is, we can move the needle. The participations are dismal. Nobody's going to want to see all private super PAC money funding all the primary challengers, although it is the most immediately readily available mechanism, and I fully applaud anybody who just works with that framing. Beyond that, though, there are things like New York City's public financing, where there's a 6-to-1 leverage, where if you get enough signatures, there's talk of other legislation. Interested first in your thoughts, Mark, and then Ari, on any effort to try to create what I call base financing, that first $200,000-$400,000 that is necessary for any candidate in any district anywhere in America to engage competitively, whether it's private or public money. Thoughts?
I'm open to it as long as it creates a responsive feedback loop. I want to make sure that whatever mechanism is put in place, the candidates, the incumbents, are forced to respond to the constituents and not just special interest money.
Well, I think you're totally right. We need to incentivize politicians to seek small donations. Right now, no one has any incentive to seek a $5 donation if you can get a $5 million donation. And in the current system, politicians are only going to try to raise the largest kind of money.
All right. But so let's back away. The rational logic is you can tie your mind in a knot 50 ways. It's easy. We have a psychological problem, which is that we know, even if we know what to do, we're not doing it. And there's such an alienating dynamic of the money and the secrecy of the money and the concentration of the money that it is precipitating almost like a molecular, a biochemical response in the people of this country, which is, get me out of here. And what we have to figure out, not the three of us per se, the country, is how do we turn the disgust of the sort of statistics that I talk about or you talk about or Ari writes about into the type of engagement we're seeing from you? How do you recruit people? What's your best pitch? I don't want to vote in the election. I think this whole thing is rigged. I host a Dylan Radigan show, and I'll tell you, as the host of this show, this place is bought and sold 50 ways, and I'm not voting. Tell me why I should.
Because the bottom line is, Dylan, we're dealing with your neighborhood, your family, your friends. And the question is, are you going to abdicate your personal responsibility? Are you going to walk away from that? Are you going to watch what's happening on your own street and watch the whole thing degrade before your very eyes? Are you going to comfortably go lay down in your bed at night and say, I don't care about
that? Well, how does my voting in the primaries affect any of that? This place is bought and sold 10 ways.
Because the bottom line is you have a 5 to 10 leverage point on your vote in a primary to the general election. We've got a lot of people.
What does that mean?
In other words, so few people vote in the primary election that your vote is worth 5 to 10 times what it is in the general
election. In terms of impact in the election.
Impact in the election. You have a lot more impact. And if you go out and just tell a couple of your friends to vote in the primary election, you have an impact. 85% of districts are fixed by gerrymandering in this country in congressional elections. It means your vote doesn't matter. 85% of us have a vote that doesn't matter in the general. If you believe that we should have a right to representation, you have to vote in the primary.
And I will say, Dylan, the only thing that the left and right seem to actually agree on now is that there's too much money in politics, and poll after poll shows that. So there's two possibilities. One is that everyone says, the left and the right says, okay, we're done with this system. Or the possibility is that they agree, okay, now we have to do something about it. And it creates an opening for the kind of radical change that we need in Washington.
Right.
And we might hit that moment. I don't think we're going to hit it before the 2012 election, but I think we could hit it after.
Yeah, well, listen, with efforts from the two of you, it will certainly elevate the temperature and I hope create roads for a graceful transition, which is where we'll leave this. Thank you very much, Mark.
Thank you, Ari.
It's food for thought. We have no choice but to deal with this. We get to choose, obviously, how we deal with it. I love the ideas of these two gentlemen. Whether you particularly love the campaign for primary accountability, which I am very impressed by and am advocating, doesn't matter. You can form your own organization. You can vote. It doesn't. The point is, if we are making our primaries competitive, that is the single greatest resistance as a people we could conjure to a status quo that has taken this country for granted based on our disengagement. And it is our engagement, however disgusting with your nose, you know, that will get us out of here. Mark Meckler, Ari Berman, thank you guys.